Hello everyone, Adam here, and today I'll be doing a penetration test of my own Wi-Fi in my house. Basically, I will show you how to crack any kind of Wi-Fi network in 10 steps. So what I'll be using is a Linux PC. This one is with Ubuntu from Canonical, and the set of tools named aircrack-ng. So there's a publicly available repository and packages for cracking Wi-Fi at this page. And let's get started. So first of all, as I said, you need a Linux PC, as my own here. And now you need to launch terminal. You need to download this package I was describing before. So we do it with this command. That's my second step. As you can see, I have it already installed. So once you have it done, then you have to see what is the name of your Wi-Fi interface within the system. So you do it by the command IP space A. So the Wi-Fi interface is here. That's the name. On your PC, it may be different, but you need to check with this command how to do it. And then we need to start the monitoring interface. So basically the command is this, but you need to adapt it to your name of the interface. So in my case, that would be this one. Okay, so this aircrack, aircrack-ng, it already switched my interface into the promiscuous mode. So then we'll be able to hear all the base stations, Wi-Fi base stations and Wi-Fi access points nearby. So let's now run this sniffing. So in this case, the command is this, and in my case, it's the one. Yeah, by the way, after you run this interface, it's better to check the name of the interface. It should be added as the next interface in the system. So that's the one. Okay, now I will run this monitoring. And now we can see all the networks that are nearby me. So I will try to crack my own network. This is the one. And you can see base station IDs. These are the Wi-Fi MAC addresses here. This is the power of the particular Wi-Fi station. These are the beacons, and the most important thing is the channel number on which the particular Wi-Fi node is operating on. Okay, so that will be all for now. I will stop this one with Ctrl C. Let's try to tune to my own. These are my own networks, so I will try to pick this first. To do it, you need to issue the command like this, but first you need to note the base SIDs, these Wi-Fi MAC addresses, and the channel number that you want to listen. So in my case, that would be the base station ID, this the first MAC address. So I will copy the command now. And we'll fill in all these parameters according to what we can see above. So the channel number for my own network is 9. The base station ID, this long hex number, is this. And then you put the name of the pickup file, the to save all the communication, so you could further decode the passwords from it. So that would be the name, maybe without the backup. And this Wi-Fi monitor interface, so this Wi-Fi monitor interface, it was from the previous command, so that was the one. Okay, so paste it, and now we run it. Okay, right now it starts to capture and save all the communication from the Wi-Fi between the base station, the access point, and particular Wi-Fi station. Some, it's probably my mobile phone. Okay, so now we can detach this particular terminal and try to force him to re-authenticate and send once again the passphrases, the passwords in a hash version, so we could decode them later on. So I will now try to stop this by Control C, and now I will open another terminal in which I will issue command to de-authenticate the terminal. So the command is like this. It's aitrplay-ng, the tool that also can make a de-authentication attack, and that I will be doing right now. So let's configure it first before we launch it. So I will now copy it right here, and let's make a number of disconnection attempts. 5, the access point Wi-Fi MAC address, that would be the one from base station ID. I will copy it from second terminal. That's the one. And the user Wi-Fi MAC address, so that's the MAC address of the terminal I want to disconnect, and I want to sniff the password from. Okay, I will be disconnecting my handset, my mobile handset, and it will be reconnecting, and I will try to sniff the password, so we'll be able to see it online. And of course, the name of the interface for sniffing. Okay, so the command is prepared, and now I have to run once again the monitor to capture all the traffic and to save it into the Wireshark pickup file. So let's start it now. Maybe I will try to put a different name at the end. Okay, now you see it working. Let's wait until my terminal shows up. So that's the different one, but doesn't matter. Yes, oh, this is the one. I don't know if we can proceed now. Yeah, that's the same MAC address. Okay, so let's proceed. And what you want to achieve, you want to get a message here in the upper part showing that the password handshake and the Wi-Fi protected access version 2, the handshake has proceeded. So let's start. You have to run all these commands by root. Okay, no data authentication was made yet. We wait. Okay, the first one haven't succeeded, so let's try with other one. Maybe third attempt. It sometimes doesn't work on some devices, it may not work. Okay, let's stop this, and I will tune the command to work with a second Wi-Fi peer. So the point is, I need to put here the second MAC address and run once again the monitoring. So we need to wait a while until we see the communication of this base station with the Wi-Fi peer. Okay, I think we can start this now. Okay, so far no Wi-Fi authentication. Maybe once more. Okay, so we got the Wi-Fi handshake. Okay, do you see it? Now we can stop saving and monitoring, so Control C. And now we should have somewhere here a pickup file. I think I have to do it by the sudo command, cap file basically. Okay, we have this file, so it was named like this with 3 on the end. And now what you have to do, you have to download the password lists that are publicly available on some pages like this one. And on this page you can find a password list that can be used to make a brute force hacking. So I have downloaded this one and I will use it, and I have also, of course, unpacked it, and I will be using this to crack the password of my own network. So what you have to do now, after you have downloaded this file, you have to use the tool named aircrack-ng. So to do it, the command is like this. And I will now issue this command here. Of course, I need to populate the options with correct values. So this is best SID. I will use this. And the name of the password frat file. So I need to check what was the name of it. Big WPA list. Okay, big WPA list. Okay, that's the one. And now at the end, the capture name. So that is the name. And now you start it and you wait. Okay, right now it tries to decode the hash passwords from the hashes that were sent during the reauthentication that we had forced the terminal to reauthenticate and sent once again the passwords. And it may take a long time, for example, something like 10 hours even, because of the size of the password list file. So we need to be patient. So I will stop this right now, because it may kill my PC because it's not so efficient. Oh yeah, I have to kill it like this. Right. So that was basically hacking Wi-Fi in 10 steps. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you like it, please leave me a like, press a thumbs up button and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much and bye bye.